we can give our investors is really to stand pat on their existing allocations. If we think in terms of the earnings outlook, as you said, we have had some nice earnings gains here into 2018, but we have, to your point, started to see those 2019 estimates start to trend downward. And so you've got a good near-term outlook, but certainly balanced by the anticipation into 2019. On an economic front, we also see a solid economy, but again, questions about potentially where that may go. So if we look at our proprietary dashboard of economic indicators, what we see right now is that the majority actually still registers on the positive side, pointing to either an expansionary or recovery. But that being said, just in the last couple of weeks, we've seen a little bit of a downturn. Mm-hmm. So our best advice to clients right now is really to stand pat on their strategic allocations.
Now, it was interesting, Lee, is that in earnings season, we kind of knew it was going to be peak earnings, but it feels like it was the broad swath of all the sectors that really stood out. What's still going to do well, and can it still do well?
Look, technology is still going to do decently well. It's just, it's going to be hard for tech to lead the market if you have such big names like Facebook and Apple having fundamental issues here. Mm-hmm. We still think retail is going to do well in 2019. The issue is the comps are going to start to get really tough here. And investors don't want to invest in high beta names against those tough comps. Mm-hmm. We've had pretty good comps, you know, this year, and that's why retail has done so well, you know, mostly across the board, except for some of the stuff that's had issues with the trade war. You know, and when you take a look at stuff that, you know, will see an impact from the rising dollar. You didn't hear too much about the rising dollar this quarter. You will hear about it next quarter because the things ticked up pretty good. You heard about rates somewhat this quarter. You're going to hear more about it next quarter. So there's just a whole bunch of things that are stacking up here, and that all leads to investors investing in lower beta names. We've seen healthcare do pretty well. It should continue to do pretty well. Consumer staples, although they're going to have problems with the dollar. Mm-hmm.
So this is some interesting outlook. As you can see, the crypto market right now is getting crushed. I'm continuing to buy the dip. And it looks like the stock market, although it's been very weak, it looks like to have at least the analysts are projecting a healthy run. So I'm not panicking on either end. I'm not fire selling my stocks and I'm not fire selling my crypto. But if you don't have a good cash position, if you are 100% equities or even like 80, 70% equities, it's time to consider getting some cash, especially as the US dollar is getting stronger and stronger. So I am not selling, but I'm definitely buying very limited amounts because I do still feel like in the next year or two, being liquid is going to be key. But let me know your thoughts, and I will talk to you guys soon.